secretary of Center for Emotional Education Society and the first Indian member of the International Association of Applied Linguistics and youth member of the Public Relations Society of India. Dr. Abhishek received his PhD on emotional language teaching from Department of Linguistics, Andhra University. He completed his MA in English Journalism, Psychology and Philosophy and qualified as UGC recognized TSAP state eligibility test for assistant professorship. He pursued a course on sustainable engineering from Sweden and has successfully completed various projects on Gadapa dysphagia, social and emotional therapy, and Gandhian communication. He was authored 27 books, written sources of research articles, and completed 25 diploma and certificate courses. He was part of more than 100 equity lectures, conferences, and workshops, has directed and acted in multiple message-oriented short films and music albums, and he is a student of PGP ex-IIM Visakhapatnam.
Yeah. Thank you so much for the wonderful introduction. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So hi guys, so I'll be starting with my presentation. So I'll be presenting for 1 hour, 15 minutes. So after that, we'll have a brief discussion on the topics that I've just presented. So good afternoon, guys. I'm Dr. Challa Krishnaveer Abhishek, soft skills trainer and linguist of Andhra University. So the most important topic presentation, because we as human beings, we always have to present ourselves at different places, at different situations. So presentation, I believe, is an integral part of our living. So there's a famous shloka in Sanskrit called Vastrena Vapusha Vacha Vidyaya Vinayena Cha. So in presentation, when you're presenting yourself, your clothes, vastram, your clothes are being seen, your vapusha, how you groom yourself, your vacha, your voice, your vidyaya, your knowledge, your vinayam, your humility. So all these skills are reflected when you're presenting. Similarly, there's something called aim calm, which I always believe in. So your attitude, your positive attitude and introspection, self-introspection, understanding your strengths, your weaknesses, your opportunities, your threats, and developing yourself based on that, capitalizing on your strengths, you know, trying to reduce your weaknesses, working on your threats, etc. And then motivation, motivating yourself and developing the knowledge, the competence, and attention. Attention is very important, paying attention to what you're doing, and adaptability, being adaptable, and open-mindedness, accepting things, and management. So when I talk about management, there are different types of management, stage management, stress management, a lot of management. So all these techniques are essential for a good presenter. So these are the basic skills that are required for a presenter. So when we talk about presentation skills, the most important thing is the medium of presentation. So the language that is used as a medium. So the language that we are using here is English. So why we are using English? Because English is lingua franca, that is language of global business. So if you're working in any multinational company, the medium of instruction or the medium of communication is English. Even in your education, when even your bachelor's or your master's or your PhD studies, the medium is English. So English is our official language, English is our international language, English is our link language, English is the language of science, and most importantly, English is the language of presentation. So the most important tip that I can give you to develop your presentation skills is to develop your language. So how to develop English language is to surround yourself with English. Try to watch as many English soap operas as possible, as many web series in English as possible. You have Amazon Prime, you have Netflix, you know, this COVID era has, you know, completely made us into these OTT platforms. So I believe that, you know, when you're watching OTT, try to watch more English serials if feasible. So that's my sincere suggestion. And apart from that, if you want to improve your vocabulary, you want to improve your jargon, so my suggestion is GRE, So GRE words, you have 101 high frequency GRE words in crunchprep.com, or you have 500 high frequency GRE words. You can by heart or memorize all these GRE words, and you can use these words in your presentation. So this will actually give a standard. It will give you a standard when you're presenting. It shows to the viewers, it shows to the audience that, you know, you're highly educated. It shows your fluency and proficiency in the language. So develop new jargon, surround yourself with the language. So for example, if you ask me what is, you know, my textbook of English, I believe the newspaper that I get daily is my textbook. For example, I have subscribed to the Hindu newspaper. So I read Hindu newspaper every day. So that is my English textbook actually, because, you know, it uses colloquial language. And, you know, you can do a lot of exercises. You can do listening, speaking, reading, writing exercises using newspaper. So I believe that newspaper is very interactive. You know, it's always novel because every day you get new news, right? So I believe that, you know, you can incorporate newspaper as your textbook in learning the language, and also surround yourself with English medium. You know, try to acquire as much as possible. Acquisition is only possible through audiovisual media. So remember that. So, you know, if you acquire something, you remember it forever. But if you learn something, you forget it immediately. So if you're using audiovisual medium, definitely, I believe that, you know, you can definitely develop your language proficiency skills. So the first part of my presentation will be on fear. So because when we're talking about presentation skills or public speaking, the first thing we always have is fear. Fear is also known as apprehension. Apprehension is fear and anxiety related to communication. So whenever we are communicating, what happens is the first thing is because we become conscious and, you know, we have become fearful because of which we are, you know, it stops us. You know, it's a very big barrier. It is actually stopping us from coming out. It is actually stopping us from communicating. So I strongly believe that, you know, if you overcome fear, you know, you can definitely, you know, be productive and effective and efficient in your presentation. So overcoming fear in oral presentation, many would speak effortlessly in informal situations. So informal situation, when we are with our friends, when we are with our parents, you know, when we are with our peers, you know, in informal situations, you know, when we are having lunch together, or maybe during snacks, you know, et cetera, you know, when we go to a restaurant, during informal conversation, during informal situations, you know, there is a lot of eloquence in our speech. There is a lot of eloquence in our presentation. But when it comes to a formal situation, you know, we stutter and stammer if asked to speak before, you know, a crowd. Even, you know, they might be our classmates, they might be our peers, they might be our colleagues, but still we stutter and stammer because we become conscious that is this is a formal situation. So would fear so much, means why are we fearing so much in a formal presentation, is because we become conscious. So that is the main reason. So oral presentation of report. So generally, you know, we present a report, you know, maybe we are trying to market a product, or we are trying to describe a new business proposal, or maybe we are trying to give a seminar on our research. So maybe you have done finally a project and you're asked to present about it. So there are different scenarios where you give presentation, and fear is something, you know, which is stopping us from giving our best. So fear, what happens, you know, when you're fearful is, you know, fear is actually synonymous to formal situations only and not informal situations. Why? Because in formal situations, as I've already told you, you know, we become more alert. You know, we start, you know, focusing on everything. We try to give importance to every single detail of what is happening in us, which is making us, you know, more irritated or more fearful. So definitely, I believe that, you know, in formal situations also, if you're able to treat formal situations as informal, then definitely, I believe we can easily overcome that fear. So PowerPoint presentation, you know, during, now we have PowerPoint presentation, but during olden days, during those days, there was blackboard, you know, then we started having overhead projector, and then, you know, handouts and handwritten notes. So basically, though you have your PowerPoint presentation, and though there is a projector which projects your presentation, I believe that, you know, it's always handy to have a handout which is having all the keywords of the main keywords on the topic of which you are giving, which you'll be giving your presentation. So always have a list of keywords with you, and also try to give handouts to the audience, to the participants of your presentation, so that you know it will be easy for them to cope up. So that's a simple suggestion. So if you're giving handouts to everybody, you know, you can easily overcome that fear aspect. So English is not our native language. So our native language is either Telugu or Hindi or Tamil or some Indian language, right? So definitely, you know, we have that fear, we have that apprehension when it comes to speaking in English, you know. But you know, remember that even for an American speaking in English, you know, they're apprehensive when it comes to presentation. Though their native language is English, still they're apprehensive. So oral presentation is a formal act of public speaking with a definitive communicative purpose in mind. So what is that communicative purpose in a presentation? Is to persuade your audience, is to convince your audience, is to give them entertainment, at the same time information. So infotainment. So the greatest fear is speaking before a group. So there are different types of fears actually we have. So there's a book of lists that lists the different things that give us fear, that make us fearful. So the greatest of all the fears is actually speaking before a group, is the number one fear of Americans, it seems. And death is actually coming at the seventh place, and with fear of snakes and insects coming in between. So remember that even Americans whose native tongue is English, even they are fearful of presentations. It's actually the number one fear for them. And death, actually, it's the most painful thing, which is coming at the seventh place. No, so you can understand that everybody is fearing presentation. So this is the case. No, but you know, why are we fearful? Because we are fearful because we might be humiliated. Maybe if you stutter or stammer, or if you forget suddenly, or if you suddenly mute, you suddenly, you know, what happens is, you know, when you're speaking too fast, or you know, if you're done with the information that you would like to send, or suddenly, you know, some words you can't remember, or you cannot you know, say certain words, you know, you suddenly, you know, some sentences or some phrases, they won't come to your mind. Suddenly what happens is, you know, you become completely null. Actually, you become null and you're void suddenly. You don't know what to speak. You're out of words. You can't recall anything. So what happens during that situation is, you know, sometimes, you know, the audience might laugh at you. The audience, you know, might crack a joke at you, you know. Something might happen. So you fear humiliation. So maybe you might be humiliated by the audience. So that's the most number one fear, you know, that we always have in our mind. But remember, that is not true. You have to remember that the audience is always sympathetic. They understand your point of view. They understand your condition, because everybody has to present at some point or the other. So definitely they will understand, you know, they will empathize with your situation always. So what is the difference between sympathy and empathy is, you know, when you empathize with someone, you know, you are actually in their shoes and you can actually feel their pain. In sympathy, you cannot feel the pain, but you know, you can just show a certain amount of concern and unfamiliarity with the situation. So for example, presentation is something, you know, which people don't do every day. No, or we don't do it regularly, we do it occasionally, right? So we are unfamiliar with the presentation scenario, we are unfamiliar with the environment, we are unfamiliar with the room, we are unfamiliar with the audience. So I think that also makes us fearful. And maybe, and the last important thing which makes us fearful is, you know, something would go wrong. So we always have this thought that, you know, something might go wrong. So this always stops us from speaking, stops us from going to presentations and all. So how to come out of, how to overcome this barrier of unfamiliarity with situation is, you know, go to the presentation hall at least 15 minutes before your presentation starts, so that you can familiarize yourself with the situation. You can familiarize yourself with stage. you can familiarize yourself with the technology, with the projector, you know, with the laptop, everything. No, try to go to the place at least 15 minutes before so that you can understand what's happening. You can familiarize. Once everything is familiar, you know, your stress levels, you know, they start coming down actually. And similarly, whenever you're stressful, my number one suggestion to all of you is to take a very deep breath. Take at least 10 to 15 deep breaths. And, you know, suddenly what happens is whenever you're stressful, whenever you're conscious of what is happening around you, whenever you're fearful, your heart starts pounding fast. So you'll have palpitations. So because of which, you know, you have to take breaths again and again, short breaths actually. So because of which, you know, you're out of breath, and because of which you're out of words, you can't speak properly. So your mind also, you know, stops working. So if you take deep breaths, you know, your heart slows down, your heart rate slows down, and you know, you can give your full attention and focus and concentration. So also, if you're 15 minutes early to the room, the advantage is, you know, you can see the audience entering the room. You know, you can talk to them, you can understand their needs, you can be friends, you can befriend them, you can, you know, talk to them, and you can familiarize yourself with them. You know, you can understand their expectations, etc. So that's an advantage. So as I've already told you, never fear that something would go wrong. Even if it goes wrong, you know, all's well that ends well. And remember and believe that audience are always empathetic. So how to overcome stage fright? Be confident. So it's easy to say, but it's not easy to practice. But be confident. How can you be confident is, you know, if you understand, I think there's a basic scientific principle where air or water flows from high pressure to low pressure. I think you know that, right? So definitely, you know, if you try to relieve yourself of the pressure, so I think how to relieve yourself of the pressure is, you know, when you understand that the audience that you're addressing to has less knowledge on the subject that you're talking about compared to you. So you have to remember, or you have to say to yourself always, that, you know, I have more knowledge on the topic that I'm currently presenting. So here, the audience is actually has no knowledge of the subject, or maybe has less knowledge of the subject that I'm presenting. So I'm sharing my knowledge, I'm sharing my expertise. So I'm sharing. So as air flows from high pressure to low pressure, knowledge flows from, you know, a person with high intellect, with high knowledge, to people with, you know, lesser knowledge on the subject. So remember, you know, if you believe that you have more knowledge than the people that are sitting before you, then you can easily develop your confidence levels. And that is true. Have a positive self-image. Avoid self-underestimation. So you have to develop your self-esteem. Estimate yourself in high regard and avoid underestimation. Never underestimate yourself. Remember that you are no less compared to the greatest speakers that we have. Maybe, you know, you can equate yourself to the great Abdul Kalam ji or the great Barack Obama. You can equate yourself to all the great leaders that you can think of. You're no less than them. We are all same, right? God has given us all same abilities. So why should we feel inferior? So, and also avoid comparing yourself with others. So everybody has their own unique selling point, USP. So don't compare yourself with others, because you give your unique thing and they give their unique thing. So if you're all alike, so it will definitely be boring, right? So don't compare. So just share your uniqueness. So, and also be determined to do something about this fear. So if you're always fearful, you know, be determined to come out of it. I want to come out of it. I don't want to be, you know, crunched by all with this fear. I don't want to, you know, be affected by this fear. I want to come out of it. I want to do something about it. So then definitely, you know, you will be able to overcome fear and start practicing at a small informal level. So maybe, you know, your presentation, if you're apprehensive about presentations, you can present before your siblings, before your friends, before your parents, or maybe before a mirror, or maybe you can take a video of your presentation and see about the strengths and weaknesses, the flaws, all the things that you can work on, etc. So keep in mind that adrenaline secretes only during fight or flight response. So you have something called adrenaline. So adrenaline rush. So it comes only when you are stressed or maybe, you know, when the situation is out of hand. So it is actually a good thing because it makes you more sharp. It makes you more active. So people are buried in their own thoughts and insecurities. So, you know, our own thoughts and insecurities are our greatest enemies. So remember, your enemy is not outside. Your enemy is inside your head. So the person who is stopping you from speaking is not outside your body. It's actually inside your head. So you yourself, because of your projections, you are stopping yourself from speaking. You yourself means I'm talking about your thoughts that emanate from your subconscious, right? So, and also they do not have time to observe your nervousness. Remember that, you know, you can actually, though you're nervous, you can transform your nervous energy into enthusiasm. Secrets to banishing fear. How can you banish fear completely? So know your subject, develop command over your subject, believe in your subject, believe in what you're saying, believe that this is true. No, when you talk, when you see evangelists, you know, they believe the word of God. That's why they're able to preach it so confidently. Because if you believe in that, if you believe in your subject, definitely you'll be more confident. And practice as much as possible. No, given, you know, whenever you find time, whenever you get time, try to practice it as much as possible. And also to reduce anxiety, you can visualize your delivery. So have a positive visualization. Maybe, you know, you can visualize a scenario wherein you have completed your presentation and people are applauding, people are clapping. Now visualize that, it gives you motivation. And also know your subject, respect preparation, prepare as much as possible, practice presentation. Relax your mind. Relaxing is important. Don't overthink about the presentation. Just relax your mind. Do something else, you know, that relaxes your mind. Maybe pursue a hobby before you start your presentation. And also before your presentation, you can actually, you know, on the day of the presentation in the morning, you can go for a walk, you can go to gym, you can play chess, or you can play something, you know, so that it diverts your mind. You know, what I generally do is I play table tennis, you know, I play chess before my presentation. It diverts my mind, you know, it actually makes my mind cool, it relaxes it. And I also respect your audience, respect the time of your audience, because your audience is spending their time and energy for your presentation. So, you know, give them that information that they require and respect them. That is very, very important. And mustering up courage. How can you muster up courage? So you can build up confidence by remembering that you're presenting to your friends. Always remember that the audience are your friends. They may be strangers also, but still remember, always, you know, put this thought in your mind that the audience that are sitting before you, listening to your presentation, are your friends. And you're all in this together. We're all in this. This is a group thing. Remember, you know, if you imagine that this is a group thing, you can present it much better. So as long as you prepare properly, your examiners will realize this from your performance and reward you accordingly. So preparation again, it's the most essential thing. And also I've told you, breathe deeply. And the first few minutes, I remember that the first few minutes are the worst, definitely. Why they're the worst? Because you're still, you know, breaking the ice. So once the ice is broken, definitely, you know, you'll be free when it comes to the presentation. So remember, fear as an acronym has two meanings. So it depends on you which meaning you want to take. F-E-A-R might mean forget everything and run. Maybe you can run away from the presentation. Or F-E-A-R has another meaning, is face everything and rise. So we will choose this. We will face everything and we'll rise. So the choice is ours. So Zig Ziglar, so he's the one who has given this quote. So fear for us, the meaning of fear, the full form of fear, the acronym fear, for us has to be face everything and rise. So that is it. So this is the highlights of part one of the presentation. So irrespective of language, the greatest fear for many human beings is public speaking, as I've already told you. So people fear humiliation, unfamiliarity. and the unexpected. So anything unexpected, for example, suddenly the power might go, you know, when you're giving a PowerPoint presentation, if the power goes, you know, what happens? So that's why, you know, I told you that, you know, you can carry handouts, or you can take a printout of your presentation slides, or you can write keywords, so, you know, which can assist you, you know, if something goes wrong or if you forget something. So overcoming fear, how can you overcome fear is remain confident, have a positive self-image, be determined to do something about the fear, practice at a small informal level, pumping out the inner resources like adrenaline, have that adrenaline rush, knowing that people don't really care about what you do, knowing the subject thoroughly, preparing and practicing, keeping a relaxed frame of mind, being empathetic to the audience, visualizing your delivery. So that is very important. So I always tell my students, you know, if you want to relieve yourself of the stress, you know, sing. Singing is something, you know, which actually reactivates us, actually. So it activates us. It makes us more confident. So there's one small song that I would like to sing for you. I think most of you might know this song, but the lyrics actually are very meaningful and they are very powerful. So in your presentations also, you can actually sing songs. You know, you can, because presentation, the main purpose of, the purpose of presentation is to entertain the audience also, apart from just giving them education and information. So the song goes like this. First things first, I'm gonna say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way the things have been. Oh, the way the things have been. Second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of the sea. Oh, the master of my sea. Oh, pain, I let the bullets fly, or let them rain. My luck, my love, my God, they came from pain. You made me a, you made me a believer, believer. So believe in yourself, okay? Always believe in yourself, because the God is not somewhere outside. The God, the person who gives you that energy, who gives you the, who gives you the driving force, is actually in your mind. So believe in yourself. So the second part of my presentation is becoming a professional presenter. So overview to becoming a professional presenter is view the venue, welcome the viewer, master your material, calm your mind, visualize yourself speaking. So these are the things we have already discussed. View the venue beforehand. Maybe in the before day, you can go and see the seminar hall, or maybe 15 minutes before your presentation, so that, you know, you can just get acquainted to it. Welcome the viewer, welcome your presenter, welcome your audience, master the material. Okay, remember, calm your mind, visualize yourself speaking. So realize that people want a winning leader. So people, audience actually want the presenter to succeed in his presentation. So remember that. Avoid all the apologies. You know, if you're stuttering and stammering, avoid apologies. Don't worry about that. Just go on. Just continue. Focus on your message, not the medium. So the message, the information is not important, and medium is secondary. And turn nervousness into positive energy. You know, some people, you know, some leaders, you know, when they're presenting, you can see them shouting actually. Why are they shouting? Is because they're nervous, and they're actually transforming that nervous energy into enthusiasm. And also gain experience. So how you can gain experience is attending as many presentations as possible. So become familiar with the venue, welcome the, greet the audience as they arrive, smile and maintain eye contact. So smiling is very important, because your face is the index of your body, and your smile is the index of your face. So if you smile, everybody smiles. Why smiling is important is because we humans, we try to mimic others. So if the presenter is smiling, the audience automatically smiles. They automatically have a smile on the face. They also maintain eye contact, give a glance at everybody. So what some presenters do is they select one particular person and they just focus on the person. Don't do like that. Just look at the gathering, give a glance at the entire gathering. So that is very important. So master your material, practice your speech, calm your mind. So release your stress, release your tension. That is very important. So as I've told you, the best thing is aerobics, you know, or the best thing is exercise to relieve your stress. Visualize yourself speaking. So success is achievable if you visualize. So just imagine yourself succeeding in presentation. Imagine yourself speaking. So then automatically you can do that. You can automatically make your dreams or make your visualizations into reality. So people, as I've already told you, want a winning leader. They want you to succeed and not fail. So you have to take their views into consideration also, and avoid, never mention your nervousness or apologize for it. Focus on your message. So do not nurture anxieties, but concentrate on your message. So gain experience, as I've already told you, you know, you can attend as many presentations as possible. And main objectives of public speaking are to entertain, to educate, to provoke, and to influence. Entertain means amuse the audience, make it interesting. Educate is inform or teach something to the audience. Provoke, to stimulate them, to make them act upon what they have learned. To influence, to convince or persuade the audience to do something. So structure your speech. Structure your speech around three or four major points. Keep the audience interested by few anecdotes. You can give some quotations. For example, I'll give you a quotation like, you know, Kagitambu nandu kaligi naksharal chadivi nanta darini chetrudaguna aksharambu yandu nardambu nerguchu chadivi natti vade chetrudaguna. So you can give some anecdotes, some quotations like this, you know, it makes it interesting for the audience. So summarize your main points in one sentence. Make sure that you end on a strong positive point. So end with a very strong quotation. So making the presentation, tell the audience what you're going to tell them, and then tell them, and again tell them, and then tell them what you have told them. So the first telling them is giving them message. So the second telling them is actually explaining the message. The third telling them is giving an example. So that's why tell them, tell them, tell them. So you have it three times. So start strong, finish strong. Begin with a question, open with a story. You can actually, you know, explain the concept with a story, because audience love storytellers actually. Start with a quote, use a startling statement. The first point, use clear language to state your point. Use evidence, both verbal and visual, to support. Give evidence. Maybe you can quote from a research article, etc. Amplify your point with an incident or anecdote that happened. Maybe you also develop logical transition or bridge to your next point. And also remember to speak slowly, because when we are communicating, what happens is we are the senders. The presenter is the sender. So he's sending the message through the air medium to the receiver. So what happens is, before sending the message, there's a lot of things that are happening. First thing is ideation. So you make an idea of what you want to speak. And then comes translation. Because you make the idea in your native language, you have to translate it into English before sending it out, right? So, and then encoding, that is giving proper structure. And then transmission through your vocal cords. So this is the process of communication. So what you have to do is, if you speak slowly, your mind will get ample time to translate the next sentence into the language of communication, that is English. So because the message has to be translated in your mind from Telugu to English, because our native language is Telugu, we are bound to think in Telugu. And close. So when you're closing, summarize your points, state your conclusion, make it relevant to your audience. So remember, so many of our dreams at first seem impossible, then they seem improbable, and then when we summon the will, they soon become inevitable. So first, you know, our dream might seem impossible. Maybe we feel that we cannot achieve it. Then improbable, maybe there are chances of achieving. And then inevitable, yes, I will achieve. So it all takes effort actually. So these are the highlights of part two. So view the venue, welcome the viewer, master your material, calm your mind, visualize yourself speaking, realize that people want a winning leader, avoid apologies, focus on your message, turn nervousness into positive energy, gain experience. And remember that objectives of public speaking are to entertain, educate, provoke, and influence. And structuring and delivering your message, three or four major points, start strong and clearly. Make use of anecdotes, summarizing briefly, make it relevant, and ending with a positive note. So before going into part three, a small song. So we shall overcome, we shall overcome, we shall overcome someday. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome someday. We are not afraid, we are not afraid, we are not afraid today. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe we are not afraid today. So we are not afraid, we are not afraid, we are not afraid. We are always strong, we are confident, right? So body language, so importance of body language. So practice before a mirror. So study your body language before a mirror. So body language reflects what you're saying. So your eye contact, your facial expressions, your gestures, your posture, how you follow time, your appearance, your grooming, your touch, everything matters. So body language reflects what you're saying. Dress appropriately for the occasion. Relax your facial muscles and always smile. Pause after each main point. Always pause so that, you know, people will have ample time to take in information. If you're giving them too much of information in a very short span of time, it will be difficult for them to take in, right? So marginal listening might happen. So the listening has to be effective and active and complete. So eye contact. So eye contact. So if you're maintaining eye contact, it shows that you're confident, you're not scared, you're not lying, and you know, you're interested. If you're not maintaining eye contact, it might seem that maybe you're scared, you're fearful, etc. So always maintain eye contact. So body language. Avoid hiding. Don't hide when you're speaking. Avoid looking nervous. Always have a smile on your face. Look into the eyes of your audience, you know. Sometimes, you know, look at the forehead. So if you're intimidated by the eyes of the audience, maybe you can look at the forehead. And also always maintain eye contact with everybody in the hall, not just one. Posture and movements. Do not shift legs. You know, don't put your legs in a haphazard manner while you're standing, while giving a presentation. It doesn't look good. And also don't do frantic sudden movements. Don't move back and forth too much. It shows that, you know, maybe you're nervous. Do not dance. You know, use open posture. You know, have an open posture that you're accepting. And, you know, when you're speaking, do some gestures with your hands. You know, what happens is, if you do some gestures with your hands, with an open posture that you're accepting things, what happens is, when you're moving your hands, the message easily comes out actually. There is some relation, there's a positive relation, there's a direct proportionality between your speech and the movement of your hands. If you move your hands, your speech comes automatically when easily actually. So always keep moving your hands, and also head movements are also important. This is for yes, this is for no. There is a universal code for yes, that is this, and no, that is this. Okay, so always follow that. Don't confuse your audience by twisting your head too much. And speak in a natural tone. You know, don't get a fake tone. Don't, some people, you know, they get fake British and American accent. You need not get that, you know, and speak in your natural tone. So body language, do's and don'ts. So face the audience, look at each person in the audience, glance at notes occasionally. So I've told you, you know, maintain keywords and glance at those keywords occasionally. And always smile. Smile is very, very important. Okay. And do not look at the mouse, get someone else to click the mouse, you know. Maybe you can ask a student, you know, to take care of the slideshow and all. So body language, don'ts. Do not hold on to anything. Don't hold on to anything. It might show that maybe you're suffering from something, or maybe you're having a lot of anxiety issues and all. So don't hold on to something too tightly, or don't hold on to something. Just keep your hands moving. Just keep your hands free. So do not read directly from the notes. Don't read directly. Maybe you read a keyword and explain on it. And do not put your hands in your pockets. Don't put hands in your pockets. It doesn't look good. Do not keep looking at the screen. Do not when you're giving a seminar presentation. So it comes to voice quality. Do's. Speak loudly and clearly. Speak slowly. Why I told you to speak? When I'm talking about when Speaking slowly doesn't mean your volume, but it means your pace. So if you are able to reduce the pace of your speech, it will be clear for everybody, and also it will give your mind ample time to translate and think about the next sentence. And what otherwise, you know, you become numb suddenly. So don't speak fast, speak slowly, and also but speak loudly. Increase the volume, emphasize on important points, and make a transition to the next speaker if there is any. Don't race through your speech. Don't speak too fast. Don't read directly. Don't talk too fast. You know, some people, you know, they talk deliberately slowly. Don't do that. Don't mumble and don't exceed the time limit. Okay. Things you shouldn't do. Don't turn your back. Don't show your back to the audience. Don't slouch. Slouching means bending like that. See the woman in the image. And don't keep your hands in your pockets. So rest the palms if you're nervous. Rest them. Open palms if you're confident. Avoid inserting them in your pockets. It's not good. The best gesture is anything that correlates the verbal part. So as I've told you, your verbal message and your body language should complement each other. Be spontaneous like a child. So I have learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. So in a presentation, making them feel good, making them feel confident, making them feel motivated is important. And for that, you know, always have a smile on your face. So there is a small song for that. Smile, an everlasting smile. A smile can bring you near to me. Don't say, well, let me find you gone, 'cause that would bring it here to me. This world has lost its glory. Let's start a brand new story now, my love. You think that I don't even mean a single word I say. It's only words, and words are all I have to take your heart away. So a presenter has only words to take the hearts of the audience. So with a smile. So these are the highlights of part 3. So practice before the mirror, dress appropriately, do not hide, maintain eye contact, do not shift legs, do not hold on to anything, face the audience, keep the palm open, do not put hands in the pocket, speak loudly and clearly, maintain normal pace, never slouch, and don't turn your back to the audience. So this is the final part of my presentation, visuals in presentation. So when I talk about visuals, you can use pictures, you can use photographs, you can use graphs, pie charts, maps, diagrams, aerial view, models, blueprints, etc. So these are used to illustrate key points, reinforce your verbal message, stimulate audience interest, and focus audience attention. So if you're showing a lot of visuals, you know, they actually help in maintaining the attention of the audience and the interest of the audience. And remember, don't use long sentences in your PowerPoint. Use bullets and short sentences, keywords or phrases. Appropriate font size, at least 28 should be your font size. And appropriate colors. The colors has to be visible. Don't use white, so that white and yellow are actually not visible. If it is a dark background, maybe yes. Spell check every slide. Don't see to it that there are no errors or spelling mistakes or grammatical errors. Check visibility, whether it's visible or not. Speak to the audience, not the visual. So this is basically a presentation that is happening over Google Meet. So definitely I can't see the audience. But, you know, if it's a face-to-face presentation, definitely see the audience and not the visual. Stop talking when making adjustment to the equipment and remove. And see, when you're doing something, focus on that. Don't do two timing. Don't do multiple tasks at once. And remove, change the visual when finished with the topic. Do not leave visual aids for too long. Decide how to advance slides. Practice advancing the slides, okay? Practice the slideshow. And also, supporting materials. So, and also, you know, there are some supporting materials that you can add, whether they are relevant to the presentations, and make them visible in the back row. And also, you know, they have to be short and they have to be well timed. I'm talking about, you know, short videos, short flash videos that, you know, that come with your presentation. They are your supporting materials and things to watch out for. Stand in a position where you don't obstruct the screen. and getting lost in digressions. You know, don't get lost in digressions and moving about too. Don't, you know, move too much. Moving too much is actually not good. It actually distracts the audience. It distracts the audience, you know, it diverts their attention to you and not the presentation. And keep an eye on the audience body language. Body language. See the body language of the audience and try to understand whether they're into your presentation or maybe whether they're sleeping. You never know, right? So just look at the body language and based on that, you develop your speech. You modify your speech, right? So if possible, email the PPT in advance. Always keep a hard copy. As I've told you, power goes off. So always bring a soft copy on disk or a pen drive and always rehearse before in the using that computer and projector. And organize in a chronological and problem cause solution manner. Use always put try to use pros and cons, do's and don'ts, and do's and don'ts, and also put it in a sequential manner. So remember, practice, practice, practice. So these are some final tips. Use topics from your own experience. Don't try to delve on topics that are out of your information zone. And develop narrative skills. Never speak without a purpose. And support your argument with interesting examples, mostly from the lives of great leaders or from your own experiences. Communicate clearly. Project your voice. Speak a little more loudly than normal. Feel unusual. It might feel unusual at first. It might feel unusual at first, but you know, definitely the audience won't regret it and you won't regret it. And the audience won't actually notice it, to be frank. So they will only notice if you're speaking softly. Communicate effectively. There is no point in giving a presentation that the audience cannot understand. Try to make it as simple as possible. And even a layman should be able to understand your presentation. Don't make it, you know, too high level that, you know, that the students don't make it too jargon oriented that, you know, the audience may not be able to grasp what you're saying. Finally, enjoy yourself. Remember that, you know, you are the star of the show. You're the star of the presentation. Remember that. You know, enjoy yourself. Be creative. Develop your own style. You know, every leader has his own style. Develop your style. Develop your power stance. And, you know, you will have your own fans. Definitely, you will have your own, you know, admirers. So enjoy yourself. That is the most important thing that I can tell you. Just, you know, feel that this is your moment. Okay, because as a presenter, definitely this is your moment. And remember, Bruce Lee said, you know, knowing is not enough. We must apply. Willing is not enough. We must do, put it into practice. So these are the highlights of part 4. So illustrate key points, reinforce verb messages, stimulate audience interest, focus on audience attention, use, you know, bullet points, suitable font size, spell check, visibility, and email the presentation in advance, keep, you know, the hard copy, rehearse with the computer, and also develop narrative skills, anecdotes, funny acts, jokes, stories. Develop your own style. So people should remember for your own style, for your unique style, you know. So for example, people remember certain leaders for their style. So use your own power stance, use your own unique style so that people will remember you for that. So before that, you know, I would like to quote from Geetanjali, written by Rabindranath Tagore. So there's one thing that all the presenters must always remember is where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where the knowledge is free. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where the knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where the words come out from the depth of truth, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way, into that heaven of freedom, my father lets my country awake. So be fearful, be fearless, see to it that, you know, your mind is without fear. Definitely we are always fearful. But try to overcome your phobias, and it can only happen through practice. So, and make your mind clear, be as truthful as possible in your speech, and definitely you will rock the show. So here we have phonetics. So why I'm teaching you a little basic phonetics, it's actually, these are part of English phonetic alphabet, IPA. So I'm teaching you this so that you can learn pronunciation of the words. So in dictionary, you have two things in any dictionary. You have actually the meaning of the word and also the pronunciation of the word. So given in parentheses. So I'll just give an overview of the International Phonetic Alphabet in English language so that you can practice the pronunciation of different words in English whenever you find time. So we'll start with consonants. So English in total has 44 sounds, out of which 24 are consonant sounds and 20 are vowel sounds. Okay. So 20 plus 24, we have 44, but here you have 45. There's a small mistake. I is repeated twice, so don't worry about that. But total we have 44 sounds. And A and the, so this articles, you know. So when we talk about indefinite articles like A and comes not before vowels, but before vowel sounds. Because A, people say that A, E, I, O, U are the vowels, but it's wrong. You have vowel sounds which are different from the vowels, and comes only before the vowel sounds. For example, we don't say an university, we don't say an union, because U might be a vowel, but ya is actually a consonant sound. So you have to use A. Okay, so here are the consonants that you have. You have first thing is pa, p. It's written as p within parentheses, that is pa. Example pen. Next you have ba. Example big. Next you have ta. Example t. Next you have da. Example do. Next you have ka. Example cat. Next you have ga. Example go. Next you have fa. Example fo. Next you have va. Va. Example very. Next you have sa. Example sun. Next you have za. Example zoo. Next you have la. Example live. Live. Next you have ma. Example my. Next you have na. Example near. Next you have her. Example happy. Next you have R, ra. Example red. Next you have ya. The J is actually not J, it is ya. Example yes. Next you have va. Example want. Next you have tha. Example thanks. Next you have the. Example the. Next you have sha. Example she. Next you have ja. Example television. Next you have cha. Example child. Next you have ja. Example German. Next you have ng, example English. And next vowels. First is e, c. Next is e, kiz. Next is a, ten. Next is a, apple, bank. Okay. Next is a, father. Next is o, hot. Next is o, morning. Next is u, football. Next is u, you. Next is a, sun. Next is a, learn. Next is a, ago, or letter. So like that, you have vowels and consonant, vowel sounds and consonant sounds. Now, if you practice these vowel sounds and consonant sounds, you can make your own sentences in International Phonetic Alphabet, and International Phonetic Alphabet will help you in pronunciation. Because in English language, the writing of the spelling of the word and its actual pronunciation are completely different. You have many silent letters, you know, and also many loan words, which makes it difficult to pronounce English words perfectly. So for that, you know, practice this International Phonetic Alphabet, practice as much as possible. And definitely, I am confident that you will definitely succeed. Okay. So next, these are your consonants. I'll share these slides. So there are a few illustrations that I would like to give you, that I would like to talk about. So see this illustration. So maybe, you know, you can have jam sessions, just a minute sessions, wherein, you know, you can talk about these illustrations for like 1 minute on what is happening in these illustrations. So if you see the first illustration, so the world looks, you know, how you see the world depends on how you look at it. So here you see, you know, one of the prisoner, he has seen the outer beauty, and the other prisoner is only seeing the, you know, the jail that he is in. So it depends on the perspective on what is or what you see actually. And people will never truly understand something until it happens to them. So you can see that the person is shouting help, help, help. No, but the bird is thinking that he's singing, because the bird cannot understand the human's language. Similarly, when you cage the birds are actually not chirping or singing. They're actually asking for help. So maybe you can, you know, give a presentation on this, a jam session on this. See the every act of kindness, you know, this tree protected the small plant from the sun, and now the small plant became a big tree and it is protecting the old tree from the wind. So unsuccessful people, you know, they have they actually consider failure as a baggage, but successful people consider failure as stepping stones. They use them as stones. So the more you know, the less you need to say. A person with a bigger brain, he is speaking less. A person with a smaller brain is speaking more. So there are two types of humans. So if you do not study, you will end up like him. So that's what the parents are telling to their children. These are negative ones. So if you study well, you will make the world a better place for him. So that's how, you know, the parents have to tell their children. So positive ones and negative ones. So don't work hard, work intelligent. So here, you know, they're pushing the box, and this person turned the box into a ball and is easily pushing it. So almost done. Oh yes. So we are always told that, you know, after school it's done, after high school it's done, after college we are done. But you know, life is in even a bigger mountain. There's a lot to climb. So people always say that we only live once. That is wrong. We only die once. We live every day. So it doesn't matter how many resources you have. See, this person has a lot of ladders, but he doesn't know how to use them properly. No, that is not how you use a ladder, right? So success is not what you see. So here you see that, you know, that maybe for the left, the rabbit on the left side, the plant might be small, but see the carrot inside, it is very big. The rabbit on the right is happy seeing the plant outside because it's big, but the carrot is actually very small. So who should be happy? Success is always not what you see. So maybe you know why I'm giving you all these illustrations is because you can develop jam sessions on these topics, on these illustrations. So see here, the people always complain. See two people on donkey's back, poor animal. If the old woman gets down, see how cruel he is letting his wife walk. If this guy lets down and if he makes his wife sit, oh, how stupid is he by letting his wife take the ride alone? But if both of them get down, people will say that fools don't even know how to utilize a donkey. So, you know, no matter what you do, people always comment on you, right? So, son, one day you'll appreciate the truly important things in life. The father, you know, made the son water the plant. Now it's a very big tree and the son is now father to a small son. And, you know, see the happiness and he's remembering his father's words. So we are too busy for improvement, right? So here he made a circle, he made a wheel, but these people are not interested because they're too busy to focus on improvements. And do good with the intention of doing good and not for attention. So this is what is happening nowadays, right? Also, you will never know what someone is going through. Be kind always. So see, people from two perspectives. A person on the island is happy that a boat is coming, and the person on the boat is happy that there is an island, land at last. See the perspectives. So this is media. See, this is what actually happened, but what the media is showing on the screen, see that. So you can actually make jam sessions on that. Some people just act like they're trying to help you, but they're not, because see, this person is not, won't, will never be able to reach this guy. There's a ladder, but he's not using that. Similarly, one close friendship is more heavier, is more powerful than a bunch of fake acquaintances. So stay in your lane. So always continue in your lane. You see what happens. This guy got demotivated because this guy found an apple. This guy found a diamond. He's taking the diamond away. So now he stopped digging in his side and he started digging on his friend's side. But actually, if he would have dug a little more, he would have found an even more bigger diamond. So he left his lane because he's confused. So never be confused. So your perspective matters, right? When a person sees a tree, he might be remembered of, you know, tables, chairs, or wood logs, or if a boy sees, you know, you can planting more trees is what you can remember. See the tree for what it is. So karma. So when you do good, you know, you get good. When you do bad, you get bad. So here you can see the blocks will eventually fall on him. So the boss is a person who makes the team do the work, but a leader is a person who is participant. So I suggest everybody to become leaders in their own respect. so you'll never understand my pain. So there's a small, you know, small thing, small cut that happened, small scrape, and she's bleeding. But the person is actually, you know, a person is actually taking a lot of pain from the back, but he's not showing his pain. Everybody has their own problems, just different levels. Remember that. So this person is thinking about the shoes, but then he sees a handicap. So your current behavior will be reflecting in your future attitude. So this person is scolding his son, and then, you know, when this person becomes old, you know, the son leaves him completely, doesn't care about him. So a person, you know, he's giving priority to his cell phone and not to his life. He took out his life support and put his cell phone for charging, and he succumbed to it. So priority is important. So success isn't always what it seems. See a lot of thorns here, right? So this is not easy. So definitely, and the sad truth of society. So money and happiness depends on your attitude and what. So this woman has only one, you know, one plant with a flower. This woman has a lot of flowers, but still that woman is more happy with one flower. So it's completely your attitude. So the thinker, the doer, a person who does, you know, he is always happy because he's always busy in what he's doing. He's always engrossed. So be careful with whom you are helping, because there's a lot of inner meaning in that. You can see the first step is, you know, this here in this, the person is also actually trying to push and kill the person who's trying to help him. The first step is always the hardest, but after that it's always easy. So you see the iceberg, it might appear small from the outside, but in the inside it's very big. So if you want to reach your goal, you know, there are a lot of things that are stopping you. You have to go through your ego, hater, society, guilt, doubt, boss, pessimist, rejection, friends, relatives, fear, etc. So definitely, if you want to make your dreams into your reality, you have to cross through all that. The more you learn, the more you see. Never give up. You'll never know how close you are. See, this person was very close, but he gave up at the last second. So never give up. Keep striving. Perseverance, patience is important. So much of our happiness depends on how we choose to look at the world. So this person is looking at the world on a positive, brighter side. And in the end, the only person you can rely on is yourself. So as I've told you, you are your own God. And so before I give the final thank, I would like to summarize the presentation once again. So there are some points. I would like you to make a note of all the points. So practice as much as possible. Transform nervous energy into enthusiasm. Please make a note of it. And attend other presentations. Attend as many presentations as possible. Arrive early. Adjust to your surroundings. Meet and greet people so that, you know, you become familiar with them. As I've already told you, make friends with them. Use positive visualization. Make always think positive. Always think of a positive outcome. Take deep breaths, always smile, work on your pauses, and actively engage the audience. Be entertaining, entertain them, you know. Say nowadays, you know, why are we always into gadgets? Why are we always onto YouTube or Instagram? Because that is what is entertaining us. So people always go towards places which entertain, which inform them, which give them information that is required, and also give them entertainment. Crack jokes occasionally, tell them stories, you know, sing songs, anything is fine. And also admit that you don't have answers. You know, people sometimes, audience think that the presenters have answers to all the questions, but it is wrong. Admit that you don't have answers to all the questions, and also sip water occasionally so that your throat doesn't become dry, your mouth doesn't become dry. And also use a power stance, develop a power stance for yourself, and always use that shinga. And don't fight the fear. Just accept it and see, you know, how your body responds. Because as I already told you, your body is designed to fight the fear. So this is how, you know, you can succeed. And remember that always the presenters are the leaders. The presenter, any presenter is the leader for the particular situation. So empower your, as a leader, you are, though you're a presenter, you're a leader. So you have to empower your audience. You have to focus on the development of your audience. You have to communicate effectively. You have to show high emotional intelligence. You should be able to control your emotions, understand your emotions, control your emotions, understand audience emotions and try to act based on that. Socialize and empathize. And you have to possess problem solving skills. Some problems might occur during presentations. Develop problem solving skills, decision making skills. Take responsibility of what is happening. And you know, respect others. You know, remember that the audience are important and cater to the needs of your audience, because your audience, without an audience, the presenter is nothing. So cater to the needs of the audience and prioritize personal development, focus on yourself, encourage strategic thinking and actively listen to what, you know, when you get a feedback, actively listen to it. And, you know, and also take accountability, as I've told you, take responsibility and show, be passionate. You know, when you're passionate, you get that charm, you get that charisma, right? So be passionate and also be a visionary. You know, if you're just a goal setter, you have something called SMART goals: specific, measurable, action oriented, realistic and time bound. So instead of just being a SMART goal setter, be a visionary. Think about, you know, 10 years, think about the future in 20 years. So be a visionary and care about others, you know, stay up to date on the latest trends, be up to date with the current affairs and lead your audience to success. At the end of the day, the presenter himself, you know, should not be successful. The audience at large, the whole group has to be successful. So that is very important. So in communication, so you have verbal and non-verbal, and in verbal communication, you have listening, speaking, reading and writing, out of which listening is the most important, and the audience are listening to your presentation. So they are very, very, very important. So remember them, give them respect and try to make your mind as active as possible. So that is very important. Try to be in the moment. Being in the moment, you know, will make you successful. So that's what I want to, you know, focus more on. And also you have different types of communication. Again, you have intrapersonal communication where the communication happens with yourself. Only one person is involved in decision making, you know, when you are making a decision or a choice. That is intrapersonal. And interpersonal communication, when two people are involved, you know, maybe an interviewer and an interviewee, counselor or a counselee, like that, two people are involved. And then group communication, you have group discussions. And then public communication, you know, public communication is synonymous to presentation, where, you know, the presenter takes the limelight. He is the one who is doing most of the presentation, most of the communication. So communication, remember, is not just verbal, it is also non-verbal. So through your body language, the audience is communicating a lot by not speaking, you know. But, you know, when I talk about chronomics, you know, by just attending the presentation in time, on time, if you're attending the presentation, it shows that you're interested in the presentation, actually. So by following time, you're communicating a lot. And also, When I talked about that SMART goal, so remember that, you know, your presentation has to be specific. It has to be measurable, how much you have developed. And then it has to be action oriented. See to it that, you are able to measure how much you have completed, and see to it that you're able to deliver on what you have developed. So that is there, and see to it that your presentation is realistic. So all the tips that you give as a suggestion to the audience are realistic, and similarly time bound. And remember that there's a time for your presentation, there's a time for preparation. So prepare yourself and see to it that, you know, you follow the time always. So that is the best suggestion I can give you. So when I talk about digression, digression is nothing but a temporary departure from your main subject. You can definitely, you know, depart for some time, but don't make it a very long-term thing. And communication, and, you know, when I talk about communication, you know, in your presentations, try to give that news aspect. So I try to give some novelty to the audience, which, you know, some topics that they have never heard of before. You know, try to give them, acquaint them with current affairs, what, where, when, why, who and how. So all these things try to explain to them, but don't bombard them with too much of information. So what I do, you know, in my Center for Emotional Education, you know, I train my interns, I train them in writing, and train them in public speaking. So this is what I've been doing, you know, and I believe that, you know, presentation skills are something that, you know, you cascade to everybody. If you start cascading it to others, then only you can develop, and then only you can become the better version of yourself. And I believe that presentation skills are very, very, very essential for your holistic development. And as we being social animals, definitely, if you are a good presenter, you can stand out and you can prove your acumen. So with this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you so much. And now I'm open to feedback. Feedback is also very important and essential, because communication is a circular process. So thank you so much. Any questions? I'm open to questions. Any suggestions? Anything else? Anything? Thank you so much. I think his name is Vamsi. Vamsi, I'm done with my presentation.
Yes, sir.
So if I'm open to questions, I'm open to feedback. So in the first slide, there's my contact. If anybody would like to contact regarding developing their presentations or developing the writing, definitely I would like to assist them in that. So I'm done with my presentation. Anything else, guys? So as I've told you, this is interactive. This is two-way communication. This is not one way. Now the time for you to be on the spotlight and time for you to communicate. Yes, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Rajshekar. Thank you so much, Arisina Aidu. Thank you. Thank you. You can actually unmute yourself, and you can. Thank you so much, Mahbub. Thank you. So negative attitude, as I've already told you, it is all in your mind, man. It is all in your mind. So the best thing, you know, I can tell you is, remember, you know, for example, when we're attending an interview, you know, generally, you know, in my class, what I generally tell my students is, you know, if I ask them, you know, who is the topper, they say, you know, they try to give the limelight to someone else. They say they take a name of their classmate or someone else. They don't try to get that limelight when I ask them whether you want to be a topper or not. But if I tell them, if I ask them, you know, who wants the job, they say that, yes, we want the job. But I tell them that, you know, the job is for the topper only. Then they'll understand that everybody is the topper. I'm the topper myself. I want the job. I want to succeed in life. So how to remove negative attitude is to always delve on the positive. And remember, you know, always remember that because we, as I've told you, we fear humiliation. Because we fear humiliation, you know, we stop ourselves from speaking. So remember that the audience is always sympathetic. They'll understand your point of view. And remember that this is your time to shine, and don't let go of this opportunity. So, you know, if you develop all these, you know, points in your mind, so definitely you can get rid of all of your negative attitude or of your negative thoughts. So remember that, you know, you're getting this opportunity because the God is willing, the God in your mind is willing. So this is your opportunity to shine. So who is the topper? If I say, who is the topper? I want everybody to say, I'm the topper. Yes, I'm the topper. No, don't give credit to someone else. Take the credit for yourself. And whenever you get an opportunity to shine, don't bother about anyone. Don't bother about your peers. Don't bother about your friends. Don't bother about anyone. Just think for yourself. Be as selfish as possible when it comes to presentation. Definitely, because I always tell my students that, you know, you have to make a mark before you go. So make your unique mark. There are a lot of people, you know, that come and go, but leaders and the people who make a mark are always remembered. See to it that you are always remembered even after you pass. So that's the thing. So with these thoughts, you know, you can definitely develop that positive attitude as a speaker, as a presenter. So remember that, you know, you are addressing your friends. So if you feel that you're addressing your friends, it will become easy for you. Yes, guys. Anything else?
Sir, good evening.
Good evening.
I am Asrin Naidu, research scholar, sir.
Yes, yes, yes.
Very nice presentation, sir.
Thank
sir,
you. Thank you so much.
As a guest faculty, sir, we are teaching in the online.
Yes.
Okay. We are asking something. Okay. Give me some advice, sir. If the students are not responded, then I feel somewhat discomfort. Can you give you some guidelines to me how to teach in the online? Just for better improvement.
So
suggestion, little bit suggestions.
Yes, sir. Definitely, sir. So the thing here is, online classes are not easy. Why they are not easy is because the videos and the voice of the mic of the students are off. So we can't monitor them completely. We don't know what they're doing, whether they're listening or not, whether they're interested or not. We never know. We can't know. We can't guess. So sometimes, you know, it demotivates us. So for example, if you take my presentation now, what I did for 1 hour, actually I was seeing myself in the mirror. I was seeing myself and speaking. It's a little difficult, you know, but one thing is, you know, if you want the students to participate, you know, for every 10 minutes, you just choose a student and ask them to explain what you have just explained, maybe explain or give their opinion or give their reflection on the point or on the topic that you have just discussed. So if you do that, I believe that, you know, it will be easy, you know, it will make it more interactive. So it's not easy, sir. If it is virtual classroom, it is never easy. It's never easy. For example, if you have a class of 100 to 120 students, it is not at all easy to monitor everybody. But I believe that, you know, if you take a movement, definitely I guess that you take attendance of all the students online. So when you're taking attendance itself, you know, you have the list of students. So for every 10 minutes after you teach a topic, so pick one student after every 10 minutes and ask that student to reflect, to give his reflections on the topic that you just taught. So with that, you know, all the students in your class will become active. And, you know, sometimes, you know, after your presentation or in the midst of your presentation, what you can do is you can suddenly ask all the students to unmute themselves and to repeat after you. So make them repeat some words or repeat some sentences, repeat a theorem, repeat something, repeat a statement, something. Now, if you make them repeat something, it actually rejuvenates you. It also gives you that interest to teach or it gives you that interest to continue. So, you know, make it interactive, sir. If you make it interactive, definitely the students will definitely be interested and invested in the lecture. And also they'll be more active because you're choosing them, you're asking them to speak. They won't be relaxed. They'll completely participate. So you can use these techniques. It'll be easy. For every 10 minutes, you just stop your lecture and make them speak. You just choose a participant, choose a student and ask him or her to give the reflections. I think that's the best suggestion I can give you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Anything else, guys?
Sir, I have gone through your introduction, sir.
Yes.
It's inspiring introduction, sir.
Oh, thank you.
Sir,
thank you so
have
much.
You stayed positive and try to do productive things in COVID time like that?
So basically, I love writing. So I've authored a lot of books. I started writing poetry actually when I was in Sweden. I loved the nature and I started writing poetry. So that's how my interest stemmed from. I love writing. So definitely this COVID time, I motivated myself because I subscribed to a lot of online courses actually. So you have a lot of online platforms like EDX, FutureLearn, Coursera, NPTEL, Swayam. We have a lot of online portals which offered online courses actually. So I started upskilling myself. So I used this opportunity to upskill myself. And also I completed all the series on OTT platforms. Actually, it helped me, you know, developing my proficiency in the language. So I believe, you know, I use everything as an opportunity. So because this COVID time is actually a free time, you can't come out of your house, you can't do anything outside. So this is an opportunity to go inside to understand yourself and also to upskill yourself to understand your weaknesses. So that's what I did. I started upskilling myself through a lot of MOOCs, massive open online courses, and also I started writing. In these 2 years, actually, I published 10 books. So I started utilizing this opportunity. I started putting all my energies into writing and also an uplift in upskilling myself. So definitely, that's what actually helped me in staying positive. And also, you know, I always try to see things in a positive note, because life is short, life is unexpected. You know, we should always make the best maximum of every moment that we live. So anything else, guys? Would like to speak something?
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Yes, I was so inspired by your words. You are just excellent.
Thank you so much.
Yes, I have a problem that I was able to speak so fluently with my friends, even the persons who are new to me.
Yes.
But I can able to communicate, but I cannot give my 100% when I am, get the opportunity to speak in front of great persons, or at least even in front of my lecturers. Sometimes I get, I get struck.
Yes.
Not because of my communication skills, it's because of my inferior feeling.
Yes.
I was unable to get throughout it.
I understand. So basically, it's because there's something called self-esteem. So sometimes, we underestimate ourselves. Maybe we feel that, we are not able to give our best. And sometimes, language is always a barrier. Sometimes, the words don't come in a flow. Sometimes, you are not able to recall the words or the phrases. And sometimes, there's a feeling, as I've already told you, when we are with our friends, we communicate freely. We don't have any barriers. But when it comes to elders, or when it comes to academicians or scholars, we stutter and stammer a lot. It happens. Why it happens is because of our mind only. So once, you think that you are the one who is the source of the knowledge, you are the one for whom people are sitting, you are the one who is disseminator of the knowledge, you are the one who is star of the show. If you start thinking like that, automatically you'll perform. It automatically happens. So the first and most important thing is to estimate yourself in high regard. So start believing in yourself. That's the first thing I can give you. The second thing is, remember that, even if it is a group of scholars, or a group of academicians, or a group of professors, remember that you are in a high pressure area and they're in a low pressure area, and air flows from high pressure to low pressure. So knowledge flows from you to them always. So remember that you are at a higher level when you are giving a presentation, and always think that they don't have knowledge on this subject, so you're trying to help them. So when you feel that you're trying to help them or assist them on the topic of your presentation, so definitely you'll have that confidence and proficiency to speak better, in a better way, and definitely all these barriers will be completely banished. Once you have this attitude in your mind that you are more knowledgeable. It might seem a little selfish, but sometimes you have to have that attitude. You have to attach to that attitude to become so for example, remember that for example, if I go to a counselor, so the counselor might definitely feel that he knows more than me. The interviewer might definitely feel that he knows more than the interviewee, but the interviewee might know more than the interviewer, but the interviewer must feel that he knows more than the interviewee in order to interview him properly, in order to speak effectively, and then in order to be confident. So develop that attitude. It might seem a little selfish, but you have to develop that, in order to become more free. So as a presenter, what I feel is that I'm actually trying to transform, inspire, and counsel my team or my audience, is what I think always. So that's what keeps me going. That's what gives me the flow, actually. And at one point of time, I never wanted to become a teacher because I was very fearful when it comes to presentation. But then, you know, slowly with practice, I understood the nuances of presentation, and I started developing this attitude in my mind. And now the words come automatically. I did not even think, they just come automatically. It's like, you know, I'm talking to my maybe I'm talking to my mother, I'm talking to my father, or maybe I'm talking to my sibling, or maybe I'm having a chit chat with my friends. So that's how I'm feeling. So this is giving the flow. This is actually helping me a lot. So I've tried to develop this attitude. Panishree.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yes.
Sir, can you suggest any writing? You are a good writer, now, sir. Write a books and all. Can you suggest any art, any tool to write something, thesis like that? Can you suggest any tool?
To write it effectively without any errors or mistakes? That's what you want to ask me, sir. You want it to be error free?
I want to write my thesis, right, sir?
Sir, if you want to write your thesis, there is a very good software called Grammarly. Grammarly.
Grammarly. Yes, sir. I know that. Is there any other than if you something mistake, yes, it will shown in the Grammarly. Yeah. Okay.
You want some other software?
Yeah, that is okay.
Which can help you?
Yeah.
Okay. Actually, for research writers, there's one thing called from MS Word, you have something called Journal Doc, where you can actually write articles directly. It directly gives footnotes, endnotes, everything is direct. So there's one software called Journal Doc.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So you can download that. It is like MS Word only, but it is useful for research scholars to write articles. So when we're writing reports, you know, we have to write an abstract, keywords, introduction, literature review, methodology, results and discussion, conclusion, reference and bibliography. So it helps you, you know, this Journal Doc, it helps you in actually framing all this. It makes it easy, actually.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So that's my suggestion.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So anything else, guys? Anything you would like to add? Yeah, good evening, Sai Kumar.
Sir, this is Sai Kumar, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good evening. Good evening.
Sir, it's really a great honor, sir, that you really gave a great presentation, sir.
Thank you.
I want to thank you in this evening.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Sir, I have a small one, sir.
Yes, yes.
Sir, for example, you are giving a presentation to the audience who all know about you, about the topic that you are going to present, sir.
Yes.
So then how will you impress them, sir, that they already know the topic that you are going to present? How will you going to impress and with your actions, with your words?
So basically, for example, for finally a BTech student, I'll take BTech students, for example. So at the end of the course and the final semester, they have to give a project presentation. They have to make a project and they have to give a presentation. They have to give a seminar, right? So when they're giving a seminar, so they're actually the audience is none but the professors of the college, right? The professors are sitting before you and they know about the topic better than you, actually. But still, you know, you have to present before them, knowing that they know the subject better than you. Yes, as you said, you know, it is a little difficult to present before an audience which is good at the subject. But remember that you can always provide an alternative perspective. There are different perspectives of giving. So I, as a soft skills trainer, I've been into soft skills training from past 7 years, but still I try to upskill myself on soft skills and other subjects, you know, always, because I try to get alternative perspectives on a particular topic. So when you get alternative perspectives, so, you know, even now I just delivered a lecture on presentation skills. Again, on the third day, you have a lecture on art of public speaking. So that the teacher, that facilitator might give you an alternate perspective on the topic. So definitely, you know, even if the audience, you know, they have competence, they have knowledge on the particular topic, but still remember that you can always give an alternative perspective. And also you have your own unique style. So my style differs from your style. No, my style or my tone of communication differs from your tone of communication. my anecdotes differ from your anecdotes. My examples and my experience differs from your experience. I might talk about leadership, you might talk about leadership, but my experience of leadership, my understanding of leadership might be different from your experience and your understanding of leadership. So definitely remember that you're always giving an alternate perspective. So for you, you know, for you, I can suggest a course in NPTEL, IITs and IISc together. They're offering online courses. I guess, you know, NPTEL, there's one course in NPTEL, which is open now on soft skills and personality development. So I suggest you to please do that course, enroll for that course, and, you know, try to get some alternate perspectives on the topic. You know, when you're sharing, so when I'm talking about presentation skills, I can give my experience. My experience can never intersect with your experience. My experience can never match with your experience. I have my own unique perspective. You have your own unique perspective. Though the topic is same, though the audience, you know, has more knowledge on the topic than you, but they will never have your experience. Remember that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's exactly your answer, sir. Thank you so much. And
thank you, Saikuma.
Your example was too also suits me, sir, because I'm third year BTech.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful, man. So good, very good. And soft skills, you know, for BTech students are very important. I think try to do a course on soft skills, a MOOC course on soft skills from NPTEL. I think that will definitely help you.
Sure, sir. Sure. I'll try on that, sir. Thank you. I'll work on that.
Definitely. Wonderful, Saikuma. Yes, anyone else? Anything else you'd like to add or talk to me or get some perspectives?
Sir, maximum of the stuff shared by you, we can't find it anywhere, sir. Even yes. You also in internet. Okay. But how you see the other side of these things, and what is your attitude towards this?
Like what? Like presentation? I didn't get your question properly, Vamsi. What you're trying to ask me actually?
Presentation.
Okay. So how I get the perspective?
Sir, for example, for today's presentation, sir.
Yes. Yes, Vamsi. Go on. Yes, Vamsi. Go on. Speak on. Oh, for today's presentation?
Sir, for example, for about today's presentation, sir. How you collect these points, or how you go through this, as these are not available internet or some books?
Okay.
How you will get these points?
So see, basically I wrote a book called Soft Skills, which is available in Amazon. So what I did was, you know, definitely I got this competence, I got all the skills from my teachers. So definitely that is there from the books that I've read. I collected all the information. But as I've already answered before, what I do is, you know, I try to understand me. So, you know, when I give a presentation, what are the things that I put in my mind, that come to my mind, or while doing a presentation, or while doing a presentation, while giving a presentation, what are the things that pop up in my mind? So I make a note of everything. So whatever I have just presented, it's actually from my own experience of what I have learned through my presentations in all these years. So I've participated in more than 150 training programs till now. So from whatever, what I have learned from all these training programs, I made a list of all the points, and based on that, you know, I developed the presentation. And the credit also goes to my teachers, my mentors, you know, so definitely that is there, but it's all my experience, you know, what I have learned through all my presentations that I have done over these years. So these are actually the points, you know, that popped up from my experiences, from my doings, from my understanding. So that is there. And this is, you know, see, soft skills are not something, you know, that have to be learned. Soft skills are something that have to be honed. Soft skills are innate. They are present in us. The only thing that we have to do is we have to hone them. We have to develop them. So all this attitude, leadership, confidence, presentation, everything, all these skills are already present in us. The only thing that we have to do is we have to hone them. We have to give them a proper structure. So that's what I've done in my presentation. So I've tried to, you know, give my point of view, give my understanding, my learnings of a presentation. So that's what I did, and that's how I developed these slides. So, yes, Vamsi.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, thank you. Anything else, guys? So in the first slide, I guess there's my contact. So if you have anything, you can email or you can WhatsApp. I'm always on WhatsApp. So definitely any questions, definitely you can always ask there, or anything you want to talk about, definitely. I'm always available in Andhra University. I am from Department of Journalism and Mass Communication. So I'm always available at the department.
Good evening, sir. Hello.
Good evening, Rajshekhar. Dr. Rajshekhar, please.
Yes. Because I'm a student. I'm also a student of Andhra University, sir. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sir, you said one poem, sir, in Telugu. Could you please repeat us for one, sir?
Yes, sir. Tagi tambu nandu kaligina aksharal. Chadivi nanta darani chitrudaguna. Ante కాగితాల్లో ఉన్న అక్షరాలు చదివితేనే మనం చిత్రుడు అయిపోము. వి వోంట్ బి క్లెవర్ బై జస్ట్ రీడింగ్ ద ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆన్ ద పేపర్. అక్షరంబునందు అర్థంబు నెరుగుచు చదివి నట్టి వాడే చతురుడగును. సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు రీడ్ బిట్వీన్ ద లైన్స్ అండ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ద ఇన్నర్ మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఈచ్ వర్డ్ ఆఫ్ ద సెంటెన్స్. దెన్ ఓన్లీ యూ కెన్ బికమ్ క్లెవర్. జస్ట్ నాట్ రీడింగ్ by just reading the sentences, you won't become clever or intelligent. By actually understanding the in-depth meaning or by actually reading between the lines, you'll become cleverer. So that's the meaning of the poem.
Nice. Thank you so much. Thank
yes. Anything else, guys? Anything else you would like to add? Maybe you would like to give a feedback. This is the opportunity, guys. Try to shine. Given an opportunity, these opportunities you won't get again and again. Try to shine in these opportunities. Try to make the maximum utilization. So, anything else? So, I guess you all have my contact. I'll just share my contact in the messenger. So I'm messaging my contact. So anything you would like to ask, you can ask there. Maybe if you're shy here, maybe you can be more free there. So it's 9908742869. I just sent through message. You can check. My name is Dr. Challa Krishnaveer Abhishek. Okay. You can always contact me. You can find me on LinkedIn also. So Vamsi, I guess I'm done with the presentation, and I think there are no more questions. So I'm done for the day. And guys, we had a wonderful session. Thanks. I have to thank you for
your. Sir, let me conclude this session, sir.
Yes. Yes, Vamsi.
Thank you, sir. Today we had an opportunity to hear your thoughts on presentation skills, sir. And this will surely encourage us, sir, by implementing in our lives. And I am thankful to the coordinators of this training program for keeping your session, sir.
Thank you, sir. I'm thankful to Professor Ramasudha ma'am and also Dr. Padma garu for thinking about me. And also, you know, I'd like to thank all the student members, all the scholars, you know, for your patient listening. You know, speaking is easy, listening is difficult, you know, focusing and concentration is very difficult. Thank you so much for your patient hearing. Thank you so much, guys. Take care. See you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir.